Hello friends, in the last video we have seen the acrosomal reaction. Today we are going to discuss the block 2 polyspermy. The sperms provide haploid nucleus as well as centrioles to the egg during fertilization. Haploid sperm nucleus fuses with haploid egg nucleus to produce diploid zygote, while centrioles are involved in the formation of spindle apparatus. Normally, only a single sperm enters and fuses with the ovum in a process called monospermy. The polyspermy, that is, entry and fusion of multiple sperms into the ovum, is prevented by two mechanisms called fast block and slow block to polyspermy. If polyspermy occurs, it will result in either abnormal cell development or cell death due to polyploidy, that is, presence of more than two copies of chromosomes. The first block to polyspermy involves changes in the electrical potential across the egg membrane, while slow block to polyspermy involves exocytosis of cortical granules in a process called cortical granule reaction. First, fast block to polyspermy. The plasma membrane acts as a selective barrier for ions and the polar molecules. It is more permeable to potassium as compared to sodium. As a result, intracellular fluid, that is egg cytoplasm, is rich in potassium ions, while extracellular fluid, that is seawater, is rich in sodium ions and vice versa. This resting membrane potential across the egg membrane is minus 70 millivolts. When the first sperm binds with the egg, membrane potential changes from minus 70 millivolts to plus 20 millivolts within 1 to 3 seconds due to influx of sodium ions from seawater into the egg cytoplasm. The fusogenic portion, that is the region that facilitates the fusion of the sperms and eggs of the binding, functions on a negative surface but not on a positive surface. Thus, upon transient change in a membrane potential from minus 70 millivolts to plus 20 millivolts, sperms are no longer capable of binding with the eggs, preventing polyspermy. This electric block to polyspermy might operate through a voltage-sensitive, positively charged fusogenic protein on sperms that can bind only with the negatively charged egg membranes. Fast block to polyspermy occurs in sea urchins and frogs, but not in most mammals. Second, slow block to polyspermy. Fast block to polyspermy is transient, occurring only for a minute. Thus, it is not effective in permanent blocking of polyspermy. Slow block to polyspermy starts after 20 seconds of sperm attachment and is completed within a minute before the end of fast block. It is a slow mechanical block to polyspermy accomplished by the cortical granule reaction. It is present in sea urchins and most mammals. Sea urchin eggs contain about 15,000 cortical granules of 1 micrometer diameter just beneath the cell membrane. Upon entry of the first sperm, these cortical granules fuse with the cell membrane, releasing their content in the space between cell membrane and the vitelline membrane. The four components from the cortical granules perform functions like: first, the cortical granule serine protease, that is a trypsin-like protease of the cortical granules, cleaves the protein posts present between the cell membrane and the vitelline membrane. As a result, vitelline membrane proteins along with binding receptors and the sperms attached to them are removed from the egg cell membrane. Vitelline envelope is transformed into a fertilization envelope through interaction with cortical granule components. It starts from the site of sperm entry and expands around the entire egg. The glycosaminoglycans from cortical granules absorb the water and radially elevate the fertilization membrane from the cell membrane. Egg-specific peroxidases called ovoperoxidase, UDX1 and transglutaminase from cortical granules cross-links adjacent proteins that stabilizes the fertilization envelope. The cross-linking protects the eggs and early embryo from intertidal waves. The hyaline proteins coat the eggs and supports the blastomeres during the cleavage. Calcium as an initiator of cortical granule reaction. The intracellular but not extracellular calcium ions are responsible for exocytosis of cortical granules. The release of calcium from intracellular storage organelle like endoplasmic reticulum in sea urchins and vertebrates, but not in snails and worms, is observed through the use of calcium-activated luminescent dye, acorin, or a fluorescent dye, FURA2. The calcium release starting from site of sperm entry to entire egg is completed within 30 seconds. The role of intracellular calcium in cortical reaction is evident from the fact that when sea urchin egg is kept in a calcium-free seawater with a calcium ionophore A23187, cortical granule reaction and elevation of fertilization envelope occurs. Thank you.